Hello, my name is Ilona, and I will continue actually, with Eurovision songs from previous years. I will try to check all countries, and this time it's Georgia. So they started, I believe, participate in 2007, so this will be the songs from this year. And 2007, Sopho, Visionary Dream. Also, I will not listen to the whole song and I will try to avoid the copyright issues. Song is weird. And of course, like always, I like all the traditional elements when countries use in their songs. But otherwise, this song is really, it's, I don't really understand it. Diana Gutskaya, Peace Will Come, 2008. Well, definitely not my favorite song. No, it's okay, but well, that's it. I remember it, but Sofia Nisharadze, Shine, 2010. Okay. This is not my type of music. Also, I don't understand these type of dances when people roll around on the floor. Eldrine, One More Day, 2011. So yeah. Well, this song I remember, I don't remember they qualified or not, because I think they didn't, but maybe I am wrong. I don't want to look up now. But this is one of my favorite songs from Georgia. Yeah. Yeah, maybe her dress is, well, it's interesting, yeah, maybe, but otherwise I don't care about her dress because I really like this song. Mm-hmm. Andri Jokhadze, I'm a Joker, 2012. Well, okay. No. Nodi Tatis Hili, Sophie Gelovani, Waterfall, 2013. No, not really for me. No, it's not bad, but okay, 2014, Shin and Mariko, 3 minutes to Earth. Okay. Really interesting performance and everything. They really tried hard, but I don't like this song. Okay, Nina Sublati, Warrior, 2015. Yes, and this one is another song from Georgia which I really like. Probably it's my most favorite song until today. Yes. Okay, next one. Nika Kocharov and Young Georgian Lolitas, Midnight Gold. Which year? 2016. Yeah. Okay. I was really surprised that they qualified, because not a lot of people like that song. Like, from what I saw on YouTube, from comments and everything. But actually, yeah, what I remember, I was happy for Georgia back then that they qualified with this song. No, it's not really my type of music, but otherwise, good that they qualified. Mara Galčeči Ladze, Keep the Faith. Ah, yeah, 2017. Yeah. Of course, she looks amazing. Her voice is also really good and everything, but this song is boring. Yes, and message and everything. I understand everything, but this song, I don't like it. I was so disappointed that they sent song that year like this before, after so many good songs. Like, not so many, but after some good songs, which they had in previous years, and then I expected something really interesting from Georgia, and same next year, Ethno Jazz Band, Derio for You, 2018. I understand, yes, of course, it's just not my type of music, and I believe a lot of people like it and everything, and I understand that it's traditional something and everything. It's not, I am not saying the song is bad or something. I think it was a good song, maybe even not really for Eurovision, but also, yeah, I don't like it. Okay, and 2019. Autonom Sadze, Keep On Going. Well, actually, this wasn't so bad. Yeah, not many people liked it. Also, I cannot say that it was my favorite song that year. But I think they really did a good job. Actually, yeah, it looks really good, everything. Yeah, look how beautiful. Yeah, well, probably you can't see really, but yes, they made really nice this, all these, like, I don't know, images, what is this, videos. I think they deserved to qualify for the final, but yeah, but yeah. Okay, well, Georgia is interesting country in Eurovision, but what I expect something more, all the traditional singing and traditional musical elements, yes, this is good, and that's what I like, I really like when a country use something traditional, but it can't be just traditional type of song. You have to add something also modern, something, make it more interesting, and maybe make it more, how to say it, appealing for the masses, because yeah, that's what the Eurovision is. But at the same time, maybe winning, only one country can win, and winning maybe is not the most important thing in Eurovision. The most important thing is probably to know your country, your culture, your music, and it is also a possibility for the artists to show their music to for bigger audience and everything. And of course, maybe it is sometimes enough if it's really a good song, and even if not a lot of people like it and not a lot of people vote for it, it still doesn't matter that, yes, the song is bad or something. But at the same time, well, yeah, it depends if you really want some results, like better results. And yeah, maybe, I don't know, maybe something. But well, this year's song was really good from Georgia. Sadly, Eurovision was cancelled, but still, despite that, I think this year's song from Georgia, 2020, yeah, was really interesting, good. I liked it. But I am still not sure if that song would qualify for the final. I kind of feel, yeah, maybe. Of course, we didn't had, what we had this year, only songs and music videos, or maybe some live videos, but on the actual Eurovision stage, a lot of can look different. It can make song to stand out even more, or it can be opposite. And you can never guess with Eurovision, actually. At the end, there are always some surprises. Yes. And thanks for watching, and goodbye.